The Truth About Pythagorean Theorem, Teenage Definition by Christine Canerva. So here's the scoop. We use Pythagorean Theorem every day in our lives. Triangles are formed everywhere, and we teenagers who drive constantly use Pythagorean Theorem, and we don't even know it. The map of Livingston County is covered with right triangles, and we live in a perfect example. Three of our most rival high schools around us, the Howell Highlanders, Brighton Bulldogs, and of course the Pinckney Pirates, and they all three make up a perfect right triangle. But as you see, if I want to go to Brighton for a game, I would have to go through Howell. The segments that make up this right triangle are called legs. So there has to be an easier shortcut, and that is called a hypotenuse. But how much would this actually save me on time? That's where Pythagorean Theorem comes in. Finding the distance. It's about 11 miles to Howell from Pinckney, and about 10 miles from Howell to Brighton. So what would be the distance if I took a shortcut diagonally from Pinckney to Brighton? We can find this out by using the formula for Pythagorean Theorem. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So let's fill in the blanks. If A equals 11, B equals 10, and C is what we're trying to figure out, then our formula will look something like this. 11 squared plus 10 squared is equal to C squared. We know that 11 squared plus 10 squared equals 325, and so 325 equals C squared. We have to square root both sides so that C squared becomes just C. So if we square root 325, C would equal 18 miles. So our distance from Pinckney to Brighton would be 18 miles. So let's track up our miles. We know it would be 21 miles if we went through Howell to get to Brighton. And it's only 18 miles if we went from Pinckney to Brighton. That's a 3-mile difference. You may think that's not so much, but it could all add up, especially if you're paying for your own gas. Now I want to find the angles inside my right triangle. This is probably going to be your longest process. I already know that one of my angles has to be 90 degrees. Let's call my unknown angles omega. You can find these angles also by using three kinds of steps. Yes, you have choices. These choices are called sine, cosine, and tangent. Each comes with a little rhyme to help you remember the steps. So, katoa. Sine equals opposite over hypotenuse, cosine equals adjacent over the hypotenuse, and tangent equals opposite over adjacent. I want to use tangent for my example. Since I just found out my hypotenuse, I could use sine or cosine, but tangent sounds fine for me today. I'm going to take the omega of tangent equals opposite of my angle 10 miles over the adjacent side of my angle 11 miles. I need to make my omega angle to equal tangent, so I subtract tangent from both sides, giving me omega equals tangent minus 1, 10 over 11. There's a special key on your calculator that calculates the answers for you. My calculator gave me omega equals 42.3 degrees. See, now I got 2 out of 3 of my angles. If needed, you can find the last angle in our triangle by using the same formulas I just showed you.